Check, ma'am.
Good afternoon, all the students. A very, very warm welcome to all of you. And we are over here for the motivational session for the webinar that has been arranged by the Training and Educational Facilities Committee. The webinar on the success mantra for the CMA exam. As we know that all of you are appearing for the December 23 term exams. So we have just completed our first session, which was from 11 a.m. to 12 noon for the intermediate students, and now we will be just starting with the final students. This session will go on till 2 p.m. and we'll start the session shortly. Just a few tips. Please be relaxed. Please don't get much stressed. You all are putting in your best efforts. You all are working hard. So definitely it will pay. Believe in yourself. You are the best. And we are sure that you will certainly rock your exams. Don't get depressed if any paper doesn't happen as per your expectations. It's a part. Winning and losing is a part of every game. So like assessments or exams are also, it has its own ups and downs. So please don't get depressed and quit from the exam if your one paper doesn't turn out to be very good. Please continue with your exams, give your exams properly, have loads and loads of water to stress out your effects, and please stay cool, chill out. You will definitely rock. You will give in your best. So we have our motivational speaker for today, P.S. Vasudevan sir. He's a leadership life coach and international trainer. So this will be a session which will be definitely beneficial for all the students, and a knowledge knowledge beaming session. And please, if you have any questions, post it in the chat box so that we can take it over. And without wasting much of time, we will start with the session. So over to you, sir.
Thank you, Madhimita madam. Yeah. Thank you so much. And I really appreciate this opportunity to talk to the future cost accountants, all future cost accountants. Recently, I was part of your campus interview for the cost accountant body. And it was amazing. So many companies, even recently, Madhimita madam is telling, you know, the whole over all the four places, beautiful placements happened. And the starting salary, average salary is 10 lakhs and went to 14, 16, 18 lakhs. I don't think so any engineer or a MBA can get this type of salary. It's not at all possible, actually. The amount of hard work that you put, yes, it is going to certainly repay. I'm going to share my screen. Yes, I've shared my screen. Let me. So whenever there is this examination, everybody gets into a bit of a fear mode, actually. OK, so this fear mode is a problem for most of us. So my sincere request is convert your fear mode into a faith mode. Convert your fear mode into a faith mode. So the more faith you have in yourself, it would be better. OK, let's first try to understand what is this fear is all about. Number one, fear is genetic. It's part of us, so we cannot do anything. We cannot remove fear. Actually, we cannot remove fear. Fear is a part of us. What do I do with my fear? We will control it. We will undergo it. We will control and undergo. These are the two things that we do in, you know, psychology, that we tell these people who have fear. Everybody has a different kind of fear. Once you join your office, performance fear, appraisal fear, promotion fear, then comes marriage fear, spouse fear. This fear will chase you. It's normal part of life. This marvel, when surf says dirt is good, I tell fear is good. Fear is the best thing. Imagine if I remove fear from you, you will become a terrorist. Be very careful. If I remove fear, you will become a terrorist. So fear is a part and parcel of us. I want you to take it. I want you to, okay, take this fear. So what does the fear do? This is another question. A lot of people ask, sir, what is happening inside me? You have a nervous system, sympathetic and parasympathetic. Sympathetic nervous system wants to protect you. Suddenly you see a tiger and you don't have fear. You want to, you know, go and pat the tiger. No. God has put a mechanism called fear so that you run away from this thing. Okay. You're taking a bike. You want to drive carefully. Then you need fear. Anything for that matter. God fear is required. Family fear, value fear. Okay. Today we are not thieves and culprits because we have a moral fear. Fear is good. Kindly register this in my mind. Fear is good. Kindly register this in my mind. This is the first lesson I want to tell you. Okay. The second thing is, whenever I also teach for various colleges, not colleges, B schools and, you know, for civil servant aspirants, UPSC, I take soft skills classes for CA, CMA Institute and other people. So people will come and tell me, sir, I don't like this subject. Okay, I like this subject. I didn't like psychology when I studied psychology. Today I love psychology. So liking and disliking is not permanent. Liking and disliking is not permanent. You like one actor, then again, you don't like. When initially, you know, there's an actor called Mahesh Babu who acts. I didn't like him much actually. But after some time, I started liking him so much. Actually, I watched every single movie of him actually. The same way, there are a lot of actors we don't like initially. And we like, we don't like some songs. So liking, not liking is a perception. It's like the school bell. Morning school bell will be horrible. But evening school bell will be, oh, really good. Okay. So they tell a joke about this liking. A guy had a girlfriend and he liked her so much. He will take her in the bullet to the temple. So every time they go in the bullet, the girl speaks, he cannot listen to it. He got very upset and sold the bullet and bought a kinetic Honda. But after marriage, he again sold the kinetic Honda and bought a better bullet with more noise. So it's always like this. So whether you like it or not, it's a perception. I had a paper called research methodology. I didn't like it. But today I'm working in it actually. For my psychometric test, I have to work in research methodology. Otherwise, it's very difficult to do a research on psychology. Okay, so don't decide, I like this subject, I don't like this subject. Treat everybody as equal. It's like a mother having three kids. She doesn't, you know, say I like, no. She treats everybody equally. Okay, so everybody has that actually. No discrimination towards subjects. The next thing I want to tell you is, in civil services, people give a preliminary exam and then comes a main exam. As soon as the result comes, the main exam comes. So what people do is, sir, I didn't give the preliminary properly, so I'm not going to study for the main exam. I ask them, are you a Kadavul avatar, God's avatar? Are you a reincarnation of Jesus Christ? Or are you a prophet, somebody? They know, sir. Then how do you know whether you will pass or fail? That is in God's hand. So prepare for your next exam. So don't go to one exam, come back and then tell, ah, oh, that's all gone. No. That you don't decide. That God will decide. Okay. There are a lot of research conducted on this, what I'm telling. They want to know who will win in a particular race, in a particular match. Okay. And a lot of people told, if India wins cricket World Cup, we will do this, we will do. No. See, end of the day, play the game. That's it. Leave the rest to God. Let's look at this video. Okay. Let's see whether the video is.
Go now, and we'll know in 90 seconds who gets the coveted gold medal. They're off at the start now, and just a little bit of jockeying for position. Soo from Korea on the inside, Turkai from Canada on the outside. Remember, nobody necessarily needs to go in front. You want to see what's happening with the skaters in front of you. Oh no, they're looking to move on the inside and then dropping back. That's basically a four-man pack now, with Bradbury in fifth. Burkott quite comfortable just ahead of Lee. Lee's got himself in good position. Again, Sue goes on the inside for the lead. the Korean in the bright blue and yellow, easy to spot, and Sue now in the lead with 6 laps to go. And then again, Ono again on the inside, trying to get some position. Looks like he wants.
So when I ask people who's going to win the race, people say, oh, okay, the first guy, the second guy, the third guy. Then they say, sir, give me 5 minutes. I'll go to Google and look at previous statistics. I will tell you. All complete nonsense. All complete nonsense.
Make the move, but he's sitting now behind Sue, ahead of Lee and Turcotte Bradbury in 5th from Australia. Now he's starting to stretch out a little bit. Field taking shape. And Ono moving up on the outside. Sue sees him coming, but Ono, there's nothing Sue can do about it. Ono goes wide and then cuts back in front. And now Ono, Lee has passed Sue. Ono is in 2nd, Sue in 3rd, 2 laps to go. Bradbury way off the pace, and Lee is now the challenger for Ono. Lee coming up on the outside.
1 down.
But Lee has gone down.
2 down.
Sue.
3 down. 4 down.
And Bradbury is in the perfect spot. States over the line.
Gee, beauty.
Australia's first ever Winter Olympics.
For that country, Australia, this is the first ever Winter Olympics. Okay. So if you see any war matches, anything for that matter, the outcome is we don't decide actually. We don't decide the outcome. So kindly don't do that after, you know, thing. And the next thing I want to tell you is when you go and sit in the examination center, once you receive the question paper, it takes at least 5 minutes and 10 minutes for your memory to start working. Immediately read the code, that's all gone. No. It's not that. Sit with that. Cool down, calm down, breathe well, then you will get into that mode actually. Okay, that's called the warm up. See, you don't go and immediately run a marathon. First you warm up, you know, first you warm up. Okay, let 5 minutes go, let 10 minutes also go. Okay, and go through those questions and see which are the questions you know very well. And for the rest of them, okay, you can put the headings and then go. Table of contents. Every book has a table of contents. Every chapter has a table of contents. What I want you to do is, what is that you're going to read? Put a table of contents in a big chart sheet and paste it in your house. Okay, wherever possible. Okay, it's called the Gajini chart sheet. And keep looking at it again and again and again and again. Another method I give people is, especially for people who are studying civil services, read the chapter important points loud, record in your phone and keep listening to it. This works very well. Lot of people say, wow, sir, it's really nice. It's like a revision. Okay. They say, only sir, my voice is bad. It's okay. You can go for singing classes later, but don't worry about it now. Okay, that's the second method. So keep. I also do that actually. If tomorrow is a very important presentation I'm going to give for the judges, so then I record my speech and then put it. Recently, I gave a TEDx speech. So for that also, I recorded my speech. Night, I was listening to it 2 to 3 times. Morning, I was going to the venue. I was listening to it 2-3 times. It's better actually. Everybody asked, what are you listening? I said, some nice songs, something. Don't tell them, you know, all these techniques. Okay. So that's the second thing I would suggest you. The third thing I would suggest you is, before exams, don't watch movies. Why? Yes, scientific evidence. When you watch a movie, the movie stays in your mind and memory for the next 2 to 3 days. Okay. And if it's a very emotional movie, it gets associated with something called as amygdala, which goes inside. Okay. And it goes on top of what you have studied. So recalling will be difficult actually. Recalling will be difficult. There is a recency and primacy effect. Primacy effect, what you studied first. Recency effect, what you studied latest, will have a lot of recalling effect actually. So it's always good that you go through it again and again and again. That would be better actually. Again and again and again. Now, Sir, should I worry about the results? When should you worry about the results? If you are undergoing any serious health problem, you'll go for a medical checkup. They will give you, the result will come tomorrow. That time you can worry. Yeah, I will also, you call me also, I will also come and console you, worry. For this exams, evening coming back and taking all the answer, whether it is correct or, never do that actually. Never do that. Once you have written your exam, it is over. Go to the next exam, complete it, and then you thoroughly do a root cause analysis of what went wrong. Root cause analysis of what went wrong. Okay, this is next one. The next thing is, some people might be attending a couple of times. Nothing wrong. Okay, even civil service also, people attend a lot of times. CA also, people attend a lot of times. All these toughest exams, people attend a lot of times. Sir, why can't they make it easy? If they make it easy, then everybody will clear. Everybody will say, I'm a cost accountant. Too many cost accountants. Why should I give 10 lakh salary? Reduce it to 3 lakhs or 4 lakhs. So that's a problem. Imagine you're taking a flight. The pilot asks, how many doctors are there? One or two will raise hand. How many lawyers are there? One or two will raise hand. How many cost accountants are there? One or two will raise hands. How many engineers are there? Everybody will raise their hand. So today you're an engineer and then you want a job. First of all, getting a job itself is very difficult. Second thing is because too many engineers. Second thing is your salary will be like, you know, 2.5 lakhs, 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs. Okay, all possible. Unless otherwise you study in IIT or something. But if you want to go to IIT, you have to write an entrance exam, which is difficult than getting into an difficult than the clearing the IIT. But see the CMA course, you don't have much. You just can get in, but you can, you have to work hard. But if you work hard, you can clear. Sir, how are you telling? So many cost accountants are available already. They all have worked hard, cleared, and then one thing. It's not the first, you're not the first batch. Sir, it's very tough. I know. Okay, fine. Sir, when can I worry if I have more attempts? If you are 40 years and above, if you have more number of attempts, please call me. Okay, then I'll talk to you. We will conduct a psychometric test and find out, is there any problem? Next problem is, sir, I have a very bad memory. Oh, really? If you have a very bad memory, then they would have identified it long time back, actually. They will be like, you know, if it's a congenital, you know, memory problem, easily they would have identified. Okay. So far, they have not identified. That means you don't have a memory problem. Sir, how can I test my memory? I will take you to a movie. After the movie is over, I will ask you, tell me what happened in the movie. Sir, I forgot. I don't know what I watched. Then you have amnesia. Then we will go for treatment. Otherwise, your memory is normal only. Otherwise, your memory is normal. Movies and all you can remember, but only when it comes to subject, you will forget. That's a selective memory. So that memory is not there. Okay, now you have another 10 days. Sir, do you think I can do things in 10 days? Of course, you can do wonders in 10 days, actually. You can do wonders in 10 days. So each minute counts. Each minute counts. No TV. And you have a hell phone. Hell phone. H-E-L-L. Hell phone. Throw it away. Okay. Who's going to message you? Narendra Modi? Amit Shah? Joe Biden? No, nobody. None of them is going to message you. Are you getting paid in Instagram for everything? No, nothing. Nothing, all, you know, throw it. And including WhatsApp, uninstall WhatsApp. I don't want you to do that. Everything uninstall and then only goal is exam, CMA. You can reinstall, don't worry. Okay, later you can reinstall. Okay, even uninstall some people also. Yes, that's better. Uninstall for some time. Yeah, tell them like, you know, please move away. Okay. So that's the next thing. So these are the things that people generally ask me, sir, examination, examination, examination. It's just a normal examination. Okay, it's not a medical examination. Okay, don't give too much of hype. You yourself give too much of hype that I don't want. Okay, let's look at this video.
Roll number 36.
Yes, sir.
Padhai kiya?
Yes, sir.
Huh? Kakapada?
Everything, sir.
Okay, okay. Chalo, then define Hooke's law.
Hooke's law. Hooke's law, page 65. Hooke's law states that as long as the physical state of the conductor remains the same,
Hooke's law, elasticity. This is elastic, no?
Yes,
huh?
Yes.
That chapter.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I remember chapter 8, page number 80. Okay. Right side, column, diagram, abbreviation.
Roll number 36 ho gaya tumhare.
Sir.
It's okay.
So give me another try, sir.
Aane do. I'm not going anywhere. Main idhar hi hai. Theek hai. But come next year.
Okay, sir.
Okay. All right. Chalo.
Hooke's law states that as long as the physical state of the conductor remains the same, the current flowing in the conductor is directly proportional to the voltage between the two points.
Very good. But ye Ohm's law hai. Theek hai, maine Hooke's law pucha tha. So next year. It's okay. Next year will
come. Soon main next year aati
hu. Okay.
Okay. So a lot of people ask me, can I mug up? It's a very tricky question. Yes, you can mug up. When you feel that is the only option available for you, mug it up. After you mug up, ask your friends, what is this? When I was in school, I mugged up a poem by Robert Frost. Two roads diverged into the wood. I chose the one less traveled by, and that made all the difference. I was always wondering, what are these two roads? Okay, like we have MG Road, we have Mount Road. So I used to wonder, what is this road? Then I asked one of my friend, he said, I don't know. Then I asked another friend, he said, no man, that is the road to success and road to failure. It's called an analogy or metaphor. Ah, okay, great. So what I want you to do is, if you have mugged up some subject, take that mugged up part and make sure which part of the table of content it belongs to. Assume you have mugged up some formula of how to arrive, NPV or IRR, go and find out, oh, this comes under capital budgeting. Okay, fine, this is it, okay. And then call your friend and ask, hey, what is this, man? Either one of your friend will be able to tell you, have some good friends or faculties or anybody. Then they'll be able to explain, hey, if you want to start a company, this happens, okay, fine. So then you have an idea. Okay, if you can understand and study, that's very good. It's well and nice. But there is one problem. Lot of people come and tell, sir, I gave 3 times, 4 times, but I couldn't clear. What is the reason? If you have a small stomach problem, if you go to the doctor, the doctor will think it is gastritis. He will give you some, ranitidine or some tablet. Then after 1 week, nothing happens. Again, you go to the doctor and tell nothing happens. A good doctor will do two things. One is to increase the dose or change the strategy and have a new diagnosis. Okay, so he will look at again and then increase the dose. So if you feel that, this I couldn't do it, increase the dose, increase your hard work or change the strategy. Then the doctor says, okay, probably this is a stomach infection. I'll also add some antibiotic to it. That problem gets over. Sir, how do I do this diagnosis? You need some coach or a mentor or a well-wisher or an expert in your subjects, in a CMA subject actually. We do it in psychology. One of this guy who couldn't clear the civil service for 3 times, he called me and said, bring your test answers. When I looked at his test answers, I found something. He has given all the theory, no explanation. He can write theories. Okay, according to Sigmund Freud and another thing, there are, three minds, conscious, subconscious, he gives, but no explanation. So this is one problem. Some of the people have too many explanation, no theory. That is another problem. Third guy, he will write whatever comes to his mind. Okay, there is always a right answer. Okay, suppose somebody asks you, how are you? You say, yeah, the correct answer is I'm fine. Or you can change and say I'm good, anything. But if somebody asks you, how are you? You say, my father is fine. That answer, nobody will give you marks actually. Your father is fine is a fact, but it is not the correct answer. Please be careful. There is a difference between a fact and a correct answer. Most of you do this mistake in examinations. So kindly be very careful, you know, about this shit. So don't say, I like this subject, I don't like, no, nothing. It's a perception. Come out of your perception. Now check out this baby. The baby is going to sing a song. Let's see how many of you like it. Next, I want to explain to you something called as neuroplasticity. Neurons, plastic, that which can be molded into anything. Lot of people tell me, sir, my father is not educated. I studied in Tamil medium, Telugu medium, Malayalam medium, Hindi medium. All nonsense. It has got nothing to do. It's got nothing to do, actually. Okay. Sir, my friend speaks good English, so he's intelligent. Nonsense. I worked abroad, even beggars speak good English. That doesn't mean they are intelligent. So forget about all these things. If you hard work, you will get the results. Sir, he got it in the first attempt itself. Stop comparing. You cannot compare. Everybody is different. Everybody is different. I'll tell you something. There is this guy who cleared civil service in the first attempt. And he was posted in one particular place. He became an IAS officer. But later he was not able to adjust in that place. So he asked for a transfer. Likewise, he took 3-4 transfers actually. And then I don't know what happened to him. He was finally got to a department which is completely useless. And there was another guy who cleared civil service in the third attempt. But that guy has excellent emotional intelligence skills. As soon as he went there, he started doing really well. And he's also from a village. He was initially posted in a village. He was able to go get along with the villagers, politicians, everything, blah, blah, blah. Then soon, you know, he reached the top level, actually. Okay, both of them met and, okay. So your number of attempts doesn't count, actually. What you are going to do in your work, then that is the second innings. That's the second innings that counts. Okay, so don't keep worrying about, I tried. Yes, you tried. For Olympics game, people try. First time, they couldn't. Second time, they couldn't. Third time, they 4 years, once in 4 years. At least you're lucky, exams comes frequently. Okay, Olympics and all once in 4 years. Okay, so don't say like, you know, I tried. No, never give up. That is very important. Never give up. Now let us look at this beautiful video.
Wan Dishan, also known as China's hottest grandpa,
80 years old.
He is 86-year-old man who has been inspiring people all over the world with his youthful and energetic spirit. He is an actor, model, artist, and fitness enthusiast who has become a cultural icon and a role model for people of all ages who aspire to live a healthy and active lifestyle. His story is a testament to the fact that age is just a number, and that it is never too late to start taking care of your health and well-being. Wan Dishun's journey to becoming a fitness icon began in 2015 when he walked the runway at Beijing Fashion Week, shirtless and showing off his toned physique. This event gained him international attention and made him a cultural icon overnight. Since then, he has continued to inspire people with his youthful and energetic spirit, proving that age is just a number and that it is possible to live a vibrant and fulfilling life at any age.
He's all about how it's...
He's just 80 years old. And you are 20 plus. Okay. So there's a lot of difference. Okay, when he can do it, you can beautifully do it. You can beautifully do it. And he started learning English at the age of 56. He started modeling at the age of 60. So let's stop complaining. Now, let me also address some of your other problems. The first problem is your romantic problem. There's one major problem. People call me for counseling, sir. Jobless. Let me tell you something. Your brain is not fully developed. I'm sorry to tell this. If you're below 25 years, your brain is not fully developed. Your brain is connected to your spinal cord. At the bottom of the brain, you have an animal brain. That's why you get anger. On top of the animal brain, you have another brain part called the mammalian brain, emotional brain. That's why you get emotions. On top of that, there is a PFC, prefrontal cortex, PFC. You can make a note of it, PFC. And then go to Google and type, at what age will my PFC of brain get fully developed? At 25 years. So before 25 years, you're going to get into some romance, love, all these things. You're going to undergo some emotional turmoil. Okay. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. If you have some nice time, okay, so sending some messages and other thing, there will be, of course, a time where you need to wonder whether the double tick has come or the blue tick has come. Where is this person? You have all problems. So kindly stay away from all these problems. Okay. The second problem. You go to a hotel. You order for, you know, some paneer butter masala and fried rice. That guy gives you yesterday chapati. Then you ask him, I ordered for paneer butter masala and fried rice. You are giving me yesterday chapati. Sorry, sir, that master, the chef is today doesn't have mood. He will basically, okay, not cook today. You said nonsense. So stupid. And that guy tells you also tell the same thing. No, when you want to study, you say you don't have mood. Then you get angry and come out. You take a flight. Flight is not moving. You ask the air hostess, what happened? She says the pilot has a headache, so wait. You get angry and shout at the air hostess. What nonsense? Flight is supposed to be on 12 o'clock. Take it. The air hostess says, you also tell the same reason. No, when you're supposed to study, you tell headache, headache, don't study. Shut up and sit down. Then you say, oh my God. And you take one of your old relative to for a surgery. They've given the anesthesia, but the surgeon has not come. You call the nurse. Nurse, where is the surgeon? Sorry, sir, surgeon doesn't have motivation. He's watching motivational videos. He said, what nonsense? Then the nurse says, you also do the same thing. No, when you want to study, you say no motivation. Go to the internet and watch all kinds of nonsense. Now stop giving all this excuse. You will not have mood. You will have headache. You will have eye pain, stomach pain, dysentery. Everything will be there. Okay, no motive, but you still sit and study. That's it. Your pain is a perception. Your pain is a perception. This lady, they have blindfolded the eyes and told, we will keep one matchstick and see how much pain can you tolerate. The lady also accepts, but this guy is not going to give the keep the matchstick. He's got eyes hidden. He will keep the eyes. Will she feel the pain? Everybody says, no, she will not feel the pain because she knows it's ice. Let's see.
I'm going to push a burnt match into your arm and we're going to see how many seconds you can last before the pain is too much. Now, I promise I'll pull the match away right when you tell me to, but I'm going to have to ask you to put this blindfold on so you don't know how much time has gone by.
Okay, right now?
Yeah.
Whew, I'm nervous. You promise you're going to take it off?
Yep. We use this arm here.
Okay.
Put this arm down.
Okay, are you playing with? Oh, I heard that. Just lit the match. Okay. Oh, I can smell it. How bad? Okay. I'm ready. I'm super nervous. My heart is beating really fast.
That was a.
They conducted this experiment and found out pain is a perception. Even for me, I thought it was pain earlier. One day I came home and I was very tired because early morning I left out of station and then, 8 hours of program, then came back and very tired. I thought I'll go eat and sleep. When I came, my nephew and niece has come. Then I said, hi, come, let's go out for dinner. And then we came back only 11 o'clock. 11 o'clock, I was very fresh. Oh my God. It's a perception. It's a pain is a perception. And the next thing is very, very important. Some people do a lot of drama before studying. Room should be clean. It should be like this. That should be like this. Table should be like this. No. And some people do a lot of planning. Still a lot of people are planning. Sir, for examination, I have no plans. Execute it first. Execute it. You don't require anything. You just have to study.
In a world where dreams seem out of reach, one young athlete refused to let anything stand in his way. This young man shows a true embodiment of perseverance and resourcefulness. Despite facing a lack of training equipment, he refused to let his dreams slip through his fingers. Instead of dwelling on what he didn't have, he took matters into his own hands. He built his own training equipment, turning everyday objects into tools of progression. Day after day, he pushed himself to the limit. Each practice, each shot, brought him one step closer to his ultimate goal. He knew that progress was made not by the resources he lacked, but by the effort he invested. His unwavering determination serves as a reminder to us all. It's not about the luxuries we have or the obstacles we face, but about the burning passion within our hearts. Dreams are not limited by circumstances, they are fueled by our relentless pursuit of greatness. Because in the end, it's not about what you don't have, it's about what you do with what you've got.
It's all about what you do with what you have. That's it. I want that. I want this to study. I want that book to study. I want this book to study. All these are sheer nonsense.
See some tricks. They want to see what you got, Zarya. You can do it.
We all complain about what we don't have. This guy, what he has developed it beautifully and kept it actually. Okay, so this is motivation. That's motivation. Motivation is about undergoing pain. Motivation is not, and I have seen some people, sir, now I cannot study. Afternoon, I will sleep, watch some TV, and then first I will eat, watch TV, sleep for 2 hours, then I'll fresh get up and study. No. Sorry to tell you, it doesn't work that way. You will study always. Sir, don't you? It's effective. Yeah, of course it is effective actually. Sir, how do you say? Give me evidence. Boss, if you are in a very good mood and study, 80% assimilation will happen. If you are not in a good mood or headache and then also study, 70% assimilation will certainly happen. Sir, how do you say so? You wouldn't have listened to a song, but you will be singing that song. How did that song, went into you? Subconscious processing. Somewhere you listen, what is the song? How are you singing? No, I don't know. I'm singing actually. Okay, so that is the way. And nobody today by-hearted the national anthem and other national songs. They just sing it actually. They've been singing it. That's it. It went into that. Even one small kid was singing. How do you know? My school they sing. That's it. So keep reading. Keep listening to it again and again. Automatically it will work. Fresh mood, fresh coffee, fresh food. Only after I eat pizza I can study. You're cheating yourself and your parents. Please. Don't do that. Sir, I'm getting distractions. You're getting distractions? Throw the distractions away and start studying. Throw that distractions away and start studying. Sir, can you give me an example? Yeah, see that there is a Russian soldier hiding in a trench. This is about the Ukraine war, actually. Sir, what is he doing there? He has to sit there like that. Sir, for how long? 1 day, 2 day, 1 week. It could be 1 month also. He has to be there. Food. He will have packaged food in his body itself. He has to eat water. Yeah, whatever little amount he has to survive. And suddenly they will give a call and say, go and attack. He has to go and attack. Sir, doesn't he have fear? No. He's proud that he's, you know, fighting for his country. That's all. Okay. So, sir, what happens if somebody drops a bomb on him? Yes, the Ukraine people send a drone and dropped a bomb on him. Sir, will he run back home? No, he won't run back home. So they say they're sending a, you know, drone bomb. Yeah. He took the bomb, threw the bomb away, and then moved. That's all. Okay. So when distraction comes, catch the distraction, throw the distraction, and go away. Okay. Uninstall all WhatsApp, GitHub, and all. Right now, it's a very important state for you. So this requires something called as a high growth mindset. Let's look at this mindset of people. Okay. Some people, they call me and say, fixed mindset. Sir, I don't think I studied properly, so I might not give my exams. Don't do all this comedy. Once you have decided, you have joined the course, you will write all the exams. Then low growth mindset. Sir, I will write only two papers are not. Go to all the papers. Okay. 90% comes from your subconscious mind. You will not know what is the result. Some people in mixed growth. Sir, I read the question paper. Only two questions I knew. I thought as well I will write. No. Sit and write. Write stories also. I don't mind. Okay. Fine. What we need is a high growth mindset. A little bit of discipline where you can do that actually. Okay. As soon as you read that question paper, it requires, again, I'm warning you, 10 minutes time for your body to recover. The sympathetic nervous system will give you flight or fight. I'll give you one example. There is a lion. It sees a couple of zebras. Then it chases the zebras. How long will it chase the zebra? A lot of people tell until it catches zebra. No. The lion knows the law of wasted effort. After that, it will take a break and then chase again, not immediately. Don't continuously study for 5-6 hours. No. 45 minutes, 2 hours, take a small break. Break means you will not get up and go anywhere. I know some people, when you take break, you don't come back. No. You will sit there. Listen to music. Only listening to music will happen. No TV, nothing. No TV, nothing. Because I know what will happen if you watch TV. Let that song get complete. That important movie scene is there. I will finish it and then... No. Please, no. No TVs, nothing. Until this exam. So, the lion knows that. After some time, the zebra knows that the lion is not chasing. What will the zebra do? It will happily start eating the grass and continue life. Put a human being there. Oh my God. Why did lion chase me? Why is the exam very hard? I am a vegetarian. Why did lion chase me? I pray to God every day. Why is the exam very tough? When will the lion come next? How will the next exam be? Where can I hide? Human being will die by overthinking. Overthinking is one of your worst problems. Overthinking negatively leads to anxiety. Overthinking positively leads to creativity. So I want you to think positively. Write down, positively write. 100 times write. I'm a CMA, write. Nothing wrong actually. Don't worry. Don't show it to anybody. That's all. Okay. So what if I fail? If you fail, get up and run. See the small kid. Yes, the kid. Yeah, that's it.
Go.
Thank you.
Sir, we have one question. Why companies are doing partial behavior with repeated attempts? People, they reject them. But if the first attempt or anchor attempt, they shortlist them first. Why this will happen?
Yes, of course. The first thing is, there is a guy who decides to basically become a first attempt from the 12th standard or after he takes it, and he does a lot of sacrifice actually. So that sacrifice needs to be honored actually. So that's a very, very important thing that we need to honor, you know, the guys who has, okay, put extra efforts for that. Now, this question arises in every industry. A lot of people ask me, okay, why there is a special privilege for this guy? Now, there is a, now I near my house, there are two kids, okay, and the father is a machine operator in a company. And he comes and tells me, Vasu, you take care of both the kids. I don't tell them, I said, buy these books, ask them to read, do this, do that. For the past 5 years, these kids has not watched much of movies and kind of sacrificed a lot of ice creams and chocolates and other thing and have done that. We need to honor this actually. So if getting a first attempt is not easy, some amount of hard work has gone into that actually. So that needs to be certainly credited actually, because somebody has done hard work. Hard work works. Actually, but now once you clear CMA, nobody tells you you have taken multiple attempts, so you're not a CMA. No, no, you still, they value your hard work actually. They value your hard work and they equally consider you as a CMA. Ah, that's it, he's a CMA. Okay, give the job. Okay, now I'll give you one more example. There is a chartered accountant who had multiple attempts. But right now he is the director of PwC. I don't want to name this person. I know there is a chartered accountant who cleared it, but still in the middle management position. One person's salary is 80 lakhs, another person's salary is 40 lakhs. So if you don't get your first attempt, you go to the company and start working. Somewhere you have to work hard. That's all. Okay. If you are an IITian, you had worked hard from 6th standard to 12th standard to clear that IIT. But so you need at least 5 years concrete. The same 5 years, if you're going to put hard work after you getting the job, you will both come to the same position actually. A lot of people ask, can you give me examples? What example? Steve Jobs is a dropout. N number of examples, Ambani, take all these examples. So the hard work, whenever you put, you will get the result. So better late than never. You will certainly get a job in this campus. Okay, first attempt got jobs, third attempt, fourth attempts also got job. Now what is that you're going to do next? Okay, put the hard work and reach the CEO position earlier, or CFO, whatever position we are talking about actually. Okay, so it's about the hard work actually. And that hard work, yeah, it's only for a few months. Now there is a first attempt. He goes to the company, but he doesn't perform. He doesn't do well. He doesn't have emotional intelligence. It will be difficult for the person to survive actually. Okay, so you need consistency also. That is what we love Sachin Tendulkar, consistency. Sachin Tendulkar, when he found out that his performance was, you know, getting affected by his leadership, he said, I don't want to be a captain. That's it. Okay. And then he put hard work, consistent hard work, and then he retired beautifully. Okay. So that's the hard work that we need to put. You continue, do again and again and again. That consistency will help you. Okay, so for me, I tried clearing my civil services. I couldn't do it actually. I tried in so many places, but I continued my hard work. And today it gives me. Today, I'm not a civil servant. My brothers are lawyers. Okay, whatever happens. But today I take sessions for judges. I'm proud to say I'm taking sessions in the CMA Institute. Okay, so I'm an international corporate trainer. So it's hard work. Okay, again, I'm pushing myself. Some of my friends who studied well, completed their PhDs are today in US actually. Okay, now I don't want to compare myself with them. I'm fighting. Okay, fine. So it's always there. There are people always. There will be people above us and below us. Let's not do comparison. Let's put our best efforts. Certainly we'll be successful. See the history. Abdul Kalam, a paper boy. Narendra Modi, Chaiwala. Okay, they all, you know, consistently hard worked. Okay, but some people become ministers young, and so we cannot take it. We cannot take it actually. Let's look at Asha Kandera.
Sir, we have one more question. How to avoid anxiety during the exams? I studied everything, still anxiety comes to my mind before the exams. Please suggest some techniques how to stop the negative overthinking. That's my last question as of now. So, sir, you can continue.
Okay, now, as I told you, fear and anxiety is a perception, actually. You imagine that something bad is going to happen, something is going to happen. Suppose a lot of people have public speaking fear. They come to me. The first thing is I take them to a school and ask them to talk to sixth standard students. I say, go take a class. Oh, you should see the amount of confidence. They talk actually. Then I put them with 10th standard. Then they okay. Then they take to the college. They slightly get a problem. And then I take them to the corporate. Then they say, sir, I said, what is the difference? What changed? Sir, the audience changed. The audience didn't change. Your confidence changed. Your confidence changed. Then we did one example. I asked my lawyer brother to send a couple of his juniors. I told my junior trainer, these are all PhD people. They are working as CEOs and CFOs. Go take a session. That guy was trembling actually. That guy was trembling because he thought these people are okay. So and so. Okay, so it's your imagination. That is what is the problem. Let's finish this video. So she didn't do school. She did her schooling. She is a corporation sweeper. You people see the corporation sweepers every day in front of your house cleaning. She's a corporation sweeper. She did the schooling. And she had two kids taking care of her parents. Husband left. She did her college. She appeared for the examination and cleared it actually. Now coming back to the story of this co-trainer, where I asked, took a couple of, you know, my brother's juniors, they were all doing law college actually, students, and then told they are CEOs actually. And he believed and then performed. And finally, I told them, hey boss, these are not CEOs, these are all things. It's a perception that you have this anxiety and fear. Okay, now it's also hereditary in nature. It could have come from your parent. It could have come from your, let me explain this to you. When you're a small baby, when you go fight with your neighbor and come back and tell you, mommy, Rahul is calling me monkey, your mother says, okay, don't hereafter talk to Rahul. So what happened? You start, you know, detaching yourself from people. Okay. And whenever there is a failure, your mother pampers you and all these things. But it's normal. They did it for your good. The second thing is another kid goes, fights with this small boy, comes and says, "Mummy, Rahul is calling monkey." "It's okay, da, he's your friend, go play with him." Everything's over. Then third mother, "What? Rahul called you monkey? Did you come? Go fight with him. Tell him he's a donkey. His father is a buffalo. His mother is a pig." And that guy starts fighting with people. And then there one more holy mother is there. She herself will go and fight with the other mother. It's about your parent. So many factors are there. The first thing, if you want to avoid anxiety, fear and all, you can meditate. Sir, what will meditation do? Meditation will shrink your emotional storehouse called amygdala in your brain. Okay, that is called, okay, meditation. Sir, what should I do in meditation? Sit. Confidence. You have to do this couple of times. Your brain will restructure. It's called neuroplasticity, but it takes time actually. This is not a temporary solution. I'll also talk about temporary solution. Okay, this is a long-term meditation. Second thing is auto-suggestion. What is auto-suggestion? Write in a piece of paper, "I'm a strong person. I will succeed. I will be, you know, like this," whatever you want, only positive statements. It is there in this book called The Power of Subconscious Mind by Joseph Murphy. You write it, read it. I have recorded it and kept in my phone, and morning I will play it actually. And morning I will play it. I'd also given a nice background song for that. Okay, so that also plays actually in that. Okay, sir, this is all very silly. Yeah, it sounds silly, but this is one of the best way that you can do it. I'm playing one of my meta suggestions. All big people do this actually.
Auto suggestions. "I am good in my work and I have all the necessary qualities to be the best. I have confidence."
This is scientifically proved. It's called the auto suggestions or meta suggestions. I want you to listen to it 5 or 6 times actually. Okay, sir, instantly what can I do? Instantly what you can do is called progressive muscle relaxation. PMR. Okay, it's a 5 to 10 minutes process. It's also a recorded audio. It will guide you. It's called the guided meditation, but it is very effective. How it is effective? Whenever you get anxiety, your body becomes tight. When your body becomes tight, your mind becomes tight. So to release your mind and body, you need to loosen up your thing. If you wanted a guided meditation, PMR guided meditation, you can take it from Google. If you want, WhatsApp me, I'll send you that audio. I have an audio for that. If you practice it a couple of times, you will get that instant effect. Instant effects could be rubbing your hands, drinking little warm water. If you can carry warm water to your, because when you get anxious or fear, your body will try to become cold. Blood goes to your muscles, not to your skin. So your skin feels cold actually. Okay, your skin feels cold. The next thing you can do is sewing action. Have you seen a tailor sewing action in your leg? That will increase the blood flow. That will press the blood flow. Okay, increase that blood flow actually. Okay, you can also carry a TikTok mint and put it. Because all the blood has gone to your brain, it will basically come down actually. It will come down. There are various techniques if you go to internet, but take it from the right person. Okay, you can really do that. But imagine you're an expert. This subject, I am an expert. Already I have put YouTube videos on that subject. I'm going to write that paper. You will not have any fear. Okay, so if they ask, give you 10 questions and then say, you know, answer any 5, you will answer all the 10 and tell the paper person who's going to correct, answer, you know, correct any 5 and then give me marks. If you're an expert, that is what is necessary, but that requires hard work. But the problem is we don't want to do hard work. Okay, if you feel you have not studied well, you will have fear, but remove that fear. Okay, so with this preparation, yes. I'll tell you my case. I go to seminars, so much of preparation and then deliver a beautiful speech. People will say it was okay. Some seminars, I go there just casually. Okay, yeah. Nothing happens. Everybody, you know, I feel nothing happens, but everybody says this is one of your wonderful session. Okay, so the problem here, don't underestimate yourself. Fear is very normal, but drink a bit of, you know, hot water. Take something in your mouth to chew. That gives a lot of benefit actually, because your mouth becomes dry. Be very careful whenever you have this fear. Okay, this light sugar also will help you actually. Okay, light sugar. Okay, a mint or something like that. You can, you know, take it. Okay, and then go. Don't go empty stomach. Empty stomach is always a problem. Some of you might say, sir, I feel very comfortable empty stomach. Then it's okay. But other people have something nice. At least a banana. Banana's got a high, you know, carbohydrate calorie. It's good for health. Take a banana. Okay, at least have a banana before exams. Okay, and it's normal. Don't drink too much of water. Then your kidney will have liquidity problem. Then again, you need to know. Don't do that. Okay, so these are some of the ways that you can take care of your, okay, fear. But if you're well prepared, there is no question of fear. There is no question of fear. And you have some 10 days, start preparing. Somebody told me, sir, what is this, sir? Just now Diwali is over and New Year is going to come in between. You know, I have some good times, bad times. They are together actually. And there's nothing called bad times. It's only productive times where you upgrade yourself. That'll be better. So write down all your subjects here. Okay, subject one, subject two, subject three, subject four. Every day you will read this subject. Sir, I don't like this subject, but you have to read for 15 minutes. Here it says 15 minutes for your subjects. It's a really hard work is required. Okay, 2-3 hours. Okay, put it 2-3 hours. Here, you know, 3-4 hours, 5 hours. So every day you will complete all this revision. Sir, I completed 1, 2, 3. No, it's not possible. Sir, first one I did only for 30 minutes. Okay. Sir, second subject I did for 30 minutes. Very good. Sir, this last two subjects, I don't like it. So I did it only for little time. It's okay. But you do all the subjects. All the subjects must be done. All the subjects must be done. This is elephant story. Very famous. When a baby elephant was tethered to a pole with a thick chain, it tried escaping. It couldn't escape. So it grew up. One guy came and saw the elephant and said, why is this stupid elephant can run away? No, it won't run away. Why? Because the first time it tried, after that, it never tried. We are also the same. When we tell something, this subject we will try, then after that, we don't try actually. Over motivation kills you. Be very careful. Okay. Don't look for too much of motivation. There's nothing called too much of motivation. Anna Kaisenhafer, they went and asked her, ma'am, what do? I study. After that, I cycle. After that, madam, I study. Ma'am, after you study, after you cycle, after you study, what do you do? I cycle. And they said, what is your entertainment? Cycling. Oh, okay. So who is she? Olympic gold in cycling. What is her qualification? BSc, MSc, PhD, postdoctoral work, all in mathematics. Okay. I will tell you one last strategy and then we will call it off. I want to tell you a story. You were watching a cartoon, Donald Duck, and then suddenly you see police. They put a barricade in front of your house. One big drama there. You run out of your house and then you see a big bush. And you go inside the bush, you see $100 bill and a photo of a Hollywood actor, Clint Eastwood. From there, you move to another bush. You see Ronaldo's photograph. And near that, you see one beautiful watch. You're checking what brand is it? Is it? It's a Cartier brand. Very famous brand, actually. Then you take a cab. You hire a cab. Looks like a dream only, yeah. A Ford car comes. You know the Ford brand. Driver says, my name is Richard. Oh, I say, okay. He takes you to a restaurant called Nick's Restaurant and you're in New York, USA. You get out of the cab. You see a banner of Johnson & Johnson. Now you see Kennedy Center. Road is full of ice. People are hovering. And then you wake up from your dream and say, oh God, it's not true, man. It's not true. I tell people, by heart this story, I'll give you a pen. 5 minutes. They say, yes, sir, ready with the story. You have to tell exactly. Yes, sir, I'll tell it exactly. How much time did you take? Just 5 minutes. I said, within 5 minutes, you have memorized all the presidents of America in the perfect order. You were watching cartoon Donald Duck, yeah, Donald Trump. Then they suddenly, cops put a barricade, Barack Obama. It was a big drama, Obama. Then you end up in a Bush, that is George Bush. And you see Clint Eastwood, Ronald photograph. Yes, Ronald Reagan, all this. It just took 5 minutes. I'll give you another story. I went to Jawahar Nagar to buy Gulab Jamun and Nanda sweets. Owner Bahadur resembled like a, okay. Owner Bahadur, he actually resembled like somebody called Shastri. He told me he got a big order of Gulab Jamun and is now over. He told it's available in the branch Nanda Sweets in Burma Bazaar. I again give the story. People take 5-10 minutes to read the story and say, yes, sir, done with the story. I said, very good. Congratulations. You remember all the prime ministers till today with that single story. Okay, convert your subjects into stories. Put videos. You will really become successful. You will really become, okay, successful. Last one video, then we will go.
In Indonesia, there is a guy with no arms and no legs, but he can shoot pictures, he can drive cars, and he can dive in the oceans. Who is this guy, and how the heck does he do it? In this small town in Indonesia, we found Zul.
Hi, saya Zul. Meskipun saya dilahirkan berbeda, tapi saya bisa melakukan apa yang Anda lakukan.
When most people meet Zul, the first thing they see is not his personality or skills. They see his disability. And it's not just other people. His parents did too.
Orang tua saya malu dan mereka memutuskan untuk membuang saya ke sungai.
His own parents could not accept his disability that he was born with. And his entire life, everyone looked down on him because everyone thought disabled meant useless. Sooner or later, that got into his own head. That's why when he was 13 years old, he tried to end the pain and kill himself.
Saya pernah memutuskan untuk melakukan percobaan bunuh diri karena saya takut menjadi beban mereka.
But one day, things turned around. He found a purpose for himself in the last thing he expected, a camera. Even though he has no hands or legs, he picked up a camera with only his arm muscles, strapped it on his neck, and used all the strength he had to press the shutter. And that changed his life. His pictures were really good, so good that people could not believe he took these pictures. He took thousands of pictures. He became popular on Instagram, and eventually he got a scholarship to study at a photography school.
Hidup saya terlalu batas, dan saya bisa melakukan apapun yang saya mau.
So he went one step further and became a mechanic. He designed his own car and assembled it with the help of his friends so he could go anywhere in the world. It's a special car that only he can use, with a brake and an engine from a motorbike, a steering wheel from a go-kart, and he calls it his own Formula One car.
Dengan mobil ini, saya bisa keliling kemanapun.
And in the future, he's planning on conquering the oceans. He's learning how to dive just so he can take underwater shots and improve his craft. Think about this for a second. Without any arms or legs, this guy can take pictures, build a career, build a car, and learn how to swim in the oceans. Disabled is everything he is not. Disabled is the wrong word to use because people like him fight every day to stay alive. They are the most able people in the world.
Great. So kudos to this guys. Let's send our prayers to this guys. There were three students studying. One guy asked the first student, what are you doing? Oh my God, I've taken this tough course called CMA. I'm studying. okay, what to do? Then they ask the second guy, what are you doing? I want to clear my CMA so that I can go to work. They asked the third guy. He said, don't disturb me. Look at that company. That company is called ITC. I'm going to work there and I'm going to manage the complete costing of that company. If I make any mistakes now, it will reflect there. So don't disturb me. Your high growth mindset and attitude. Hard work. Hard work. For the civil services, people study for 12 to 16 hours. 12 to 16 hours. Okay. So use that. You can study in the night. You can study in the day. So no problem. Don't worry. You can be a early, bird, or you can be a late night owl. Nothing wrong. Study, study, study. That's the only focus that you will have. Great. Thanks for having me. Any questions, please put it across. Any questions, please put it across. You can also mail me. You can also mail the institute. They can forward the question to me. So anything is possible. Any questions anybody would like to ask, please? Campus is a beautiful place to get placed. Apart from campus, also throughout the year, there are a lot of placements happening for cost accountants. Okay. So it's not that only in campus, no. Okay. So a lot of people, even I placed a couple of cost accountants in Ramco's and other places. Reference, build your network. That will help you to get placed. That is also there, actually. And once you go, then start working hard. You need to put twice hard work when you get into corporates, actually. Yes, I worked in IBM, so we all literally worked 20 hours those days, those years. Okay, we had fun also, nothing. Okay. Any other questions? Negative thinking. There are ants and ponds, ants, automatic negative thinking. Why? Because our parents don't do this. Don't touch that. We were told what not to do. What to do, they never told us. That's a problem. Okay, don't touch that. Don't touch this. So negative thoughts side by side, it will be running. We cannot remove negative thoughts on all, actually. Okay. So negative thoughts, then positive thoughts, positive, optimistic thoughts. Friends who can talk positively. Books, which gives you positivity. Okay. So these two things can help you right now, actually. Okay. Overthinking people, put a rubber hand in your hand. Okay. This is a technique I'll tell you for overthinking. Put a rubber band. Okay. Normal rubber band. Don't put some tight rubber band. Whenever you catch you overthinking, just pull it and leave it. Oh, light pain. Yeah. The brain will get conditioned. You will start reducing it. Okay. Don't put it. Don't get any serious, skin problems. Just a normal rubber band, put it and then, put it. And wearing that rubber band itself will condition you not to overthink. Okay. How to forget the past? Yeah, I know, understand some people have some past problems. The more, okay, like I have water here, dirty water here. I need to remove the dirty water, but I cannot pour it. So I keep adding, fresh water into this. Okay, so the dirty water will go off. We all will have some past. Everybody has some past problem. Childhood problems, childhood traumas, parental problems, society problems. Okay, so all this. Okay, in fact, even I had a father who used to kick me. Okay, and no pocket money. He stitched pants without pocket. He said, you're asking pocket money. We all had this, but he's a nice person. Okay, today I'm sitting in a house which was given to me by him, actually. Okay, we will have some past problems. If it's very serious, then you can give me a call. Okay, if it's normal, then please get along with life, actually. Have your religious practices, spiritual practices, which can help you like anything. Doing house domestic chores, housework, talking to your parents and friends, relatives. Okay, fine. Whether you like them or not, that's not the case. Automatically, you will release oxytocin, a good hormone. Okay, reading some good books. Okay, talking to good friends. All these can help you come out of your past, actually. Everybody has a past failure. I was a football player. I had to undergo a knee surgery. After that, no football. I wanted to become a UPSC civil servant. I'm doing well right now. Okay, I'm happy. Any other questions? Any other questions, please? You have my mail ID. You can mail. You have the institute mail ID. You have amazing, you know, administrators in your institute. They put their heart and soul and see to that. During I was part of your campus placement for the institute. I was sitting there. The amount of work that has been done, I think we need to give a special thanks and mention to all this administrative staff and the council members. They are really doing, taking good care of you, actually. Okay, such a beautiful institute. Okay, if you go to engineering college, and some of the other bodies also had been, B schools also, nobody takes care of you. But here they take care of you like anything. Thank you. Thank you so much. And thanks for having. If you don't have any questions, then if anybody would like to propose a word of thanks.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
Shall we call it a day?
1 minute, sir. I thanks to everyone who attend the seminar. Your active participation and enthusiasm made it success. And a special thanks to our speaker.
Thank you.
Who shared their knowledge.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much. All the best. Do well. You will certainly succeed. OK.